Time to shoot and get the takedown. Shoot and get that takedown. Man, your next opponent is gonna be no match for you. Beautiful combo. Keep at it. Well done. Seconds. Hey. Let's stay busy. Oh, that was good. Strong takedown. Love the way you attack those legs. Man, it's crazy. Seems like just yesterday you staring up at the posters all wide-eyed. You've been through a lot. Hell, I put you through a lot. But it was all for one reason, to get you here. Your first UFC championship. I just want to say, no matter what happens out there, I'm proud of you. I'm proud of the fighter you've become. Yeah. Don't get me wrong, though. If you lose, I'm gonna have to bust you up in the gym next week. I already made space on the wall for a new picture, and you know how much I hate redecorating, right? So let's go get that belt, champ.
So after a long run through the middleweight ranks, here he is making the walk to the octagon for his first championship fight at 185 pounds. And this man hasn't just worked his way up the rankings. He has taken on all comers, and more often than not, he has taken out the opposition. So with the win streak in tow, now the challenges get bigger, and of course, none bigger than the incumbent, the UFC middleweight champion. We'll see how his style matches up tonight. So here's the undisputed UFC middleweight champion of the world making the walk, looking to defend his title. It is certainly something that he's been able to do in the past. He has been challenged on this title run. It's not as though he has run roughshod through this division, but they're all still chasing him at 185 pounds tonight. At least on paper, could be his most difficult challenge to date. We'll be right back. now our tale of the tape for this middleweight championship fight. More than a decade separates these two fighters when it comes to the age. Some differences in height and reach. All right, we send it inside the octagon to the veteran voice, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. When the action begins, our referee in charge, Herb Dean. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas, it's time! 5 rounds for the undisputed UFC Middleweight Championship of the World. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 24 wins, 8 losses. He stands 6 feet 4 inches tall, weighing in at 185 pounds. Fighting out of Buckburg, South Africa, presenting the challenger, El Toro. And now introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 32 wins, 11 losses. He stands 6 feet tall, weighing in at 185 pounds. Fighting in Sydney, New South Wales, Australia. Ladies and gentlemen, the reigning, defending UFC middleweight champion, Robert Whittaker!
All right, this is for the championship. You've been given your instructions in the dressing room. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. We will have a clean fight. Touch gloves. Let's make it official.
Ready.
So here we go with round one, classic matchup of striker versus striker. These guys have both faced a lot of grapplers in the past. They like to draw tonight.
Oh yeah, they love seeing an opponent that will not be trying to dive at their legs. They know when they get to the center of the octagon, the only steps back they will take is if they choose to move out of range to re-enter back into the striking realm. It's a very comforting thought for both of these competitors.
Blocks the shot there, lands that straight counter.
Nice.
Oh, Superman punch. Not always easy to execute. He did so there.
Left hand punch in the clinch.
Oh, perfect head kick there. Oh, really using his reach advantage there as he lands the punch, DC.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one up? Real quick leg kick.
Ooh. Oh, straight right. Straight right hand now just misses. Oh! Head kick there, blocked by Robert Whittaker.
Big kick lands.
Oh, massive head kick there. We'll see if he can finish. Just out of range with that right hand.
That was Cain Velasquez's punch of choice. Every time he landed that overhand right, he hurt people bad. And this guy has his corner hurt very badly.
Now a kick to the body. Whoa!
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Oh, nice check on the leg kick offering there. Oh, man, that's a nice kick right there.
He's doing a great job of landing that kick over and over. What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Go finish this fight.
Back to the feet.
That one landed clean.
Sergio Pettis continues to attack that lead leg.
Big power punch land. Now he gets back in range.
Back and forth we go. Timing his shots pretty well here early, DC.
He's doing a great job of mixing things up, keeping busy, being very active.
All right, so there's the end of the round. Few things in MMA more devastating than a head kick, and nearly produced a knockout for him there.
We talked to him earlier in the week, and he talked about chances to take the kicks high. He got a chance, he took it, he landed that kick and almost got the fight finished. Let's see if he can go and do that again.
Oh, lands a stiff punch there. Nice connection.
Oh, nice land.
Back to the leg kick now. That one's no good. Oh! Oh! This fight's going to be over, DC.
What a great way of mixing up his attack. He didn't stay the course. He mixed it up. He went high when his opponent thought he was going low. Now he's got him hurt very badly.
All right, well, he's landed some good shots tonight. Right to the target. Let's see if his opponent can survive.
I cannot believe he is still standing after taking that punch. It's messed up really bad. He's throwing every part of himself into these big leg kicks.
Oh! Wow! And just like that, the fight is over.
He's done. He's done.
You knew if he landed that weapon repeatedly, it could be a short night for his opponent. But that was just one perfectly placed strike that his opponent candidly didn't even see coming. It landed flush, and the rest, as they say, is history. Big knockout win for him here tonight. And there is the UFC middleweight champion. Hard to be much more impressive than that on the biggest of stages. A knockout win to leave as the middleweight king.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 1 minute, 30 seconds of round number two. Declaring the winner by knockout and...